All right, it is time for another story on the go. So let me tell you all about my time in the Nalaboki Forest. Many times, plural. Time as in at least 10 experiences with one of the most amazing people I've ever met, Vadim Sidorovich. Links to him in the description below and his eco station and his research. He's an amazing zoologist associated with Belarusian State University and also Oxford University. Published many, many times. The guy is amazing. Let me tell you a bit about when I met him and my experiences learning how to track wolves and truly appreciate nature in a whole new way. So, I had just met, I just got to Belarus and I just met some friends in the photography world and I was interested in wildlife. I just recently started to get interested in wildlife. And so, long story short, a connection through a connection through a connection, I find, ultimately, this guy Vadim living in his field station in the Nalaboki Forest. So if you don't know anything about the Nalaboki Forest, you should do some research and also watch the movie Defiance. There's a lot of history about the Nalaboki Forest, World War II, lots of crazy things have happened there. You should totally look into it. It's a beautiful place. And you know, there haven't been that many tourists there, so there's still a lot of like World War II artifacts sitting around in the forest that nobody's uncovered or come across. All the dugouts are still there as well, where they hid and where they lived. So one story I want to tell in the Nalaboki Forest before I get to the wolf tracking is this. There's this one time when Vadim and I were walking through the forest and we saw some bison. The bison are hanging out in the forest, right? And we wanted to sort of push them into this clearing where they can graze better. And also we had some photographers out there in this field that could get some good photos. And so we felt it was good to push them out. And so Vadim and I are walking slowly, carefully, quietly. They're very shy, these bison. Not like in Yellowstone, not like throughout America where you've seen bison or maybe in Poland or anything. In this particular place, they're really, really shy. Wild bison, not used to people. So we were walking along, all of a sudden he goes, shh, shh, shh. Vadim says, shh, I see them. And so indeed, he sees the bison. And they're there, and he lets me take a couple photos, and then we go. What do? We chase after them. We start running them and pushing them, and we're running. It's hilarious. And so we're going, and here's the thing. I trip and I fall. What did I trip and fall over? A pot from World War II. No kidding. A cooking pot. Seriously. That's what I tripped over in the forest. Crazy. So let's get this straight again. I'm chasing wild bison through a forest in Belarus, and I trip over World War II pot. It's crazy, crazy, man. Anyway, what I really learned under Vadim was wolf tracking, wildlife tracking, an appreciation of their behavior, going beyond the mere tourism of photographing, going beyond that and truly appreciating wildlife. You know, Vadim didn't really ever care about trying to get pretty photos. He was interested in understanding what was happening, the dynamics of the species population, their interactions with other species, etc. And I learned so much from him as a result. I learned how to study like tracking patterns. I understand now how to use camera trap data a little bit. I understand about scratching and marking. I understand about interactions with other species. I understand seasonal changes and how it can impact the behavior of the wildlife. I understand how to look for scat and what that information can tell us. There's so much now that I totally understand that I never understood before, thanks to Vadim's work. So wolf tracking, my goodness, it's just incredible the amount of knowledge now that I have as a result of that. But there's one story in particular I want to tell, and that's, I'm gonna tattle on Vadim a little bit here. The first time I ever met him. So when I first met him through these photographer friends, he wasn't really polished and ready for tourists. He was used to having researchers work with him. And here's me, this silly little tourist, coming to hang out with Vadim. He's not ready for this. He has no idea that I'm soft as it comes and just not ready for the kind of intensity that he does in nature. Anyway, so that first time, I'm with my partner and we go. And we meet him about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. I think that's about right. He gives us some food at the field station. And he says, okay, we're going to go out. I have some other researchers with me. They're out in the field. And we're going to go out and we're going to go out for just about an hour or so. And we'll come back. Okay, no problem. Drop off our stuff. Don't bring a lot of things. It's a quick walk. It's an orientation, an introduction to the park. We understood it to be an introduction to the forest, let's say. And off we go. And he's going at this pace. He's walking at this pace. It's insane. He's almost running. I don't know how. And it's like thick, either marsh or bush up to your knees, you know, and shrubs and stuff. And it's really hard to get through. And he's not going on any roads. We're just going straight through bushes and trees. Just cover your face and go right through. And it's such crazy fast. We're trying our best to keep up. But he is just charging ahead. And we're going and going and going and going and going. It's hours later. And we've checked a couple camera traps, like pulled out the SD card, checked in on his camera, looked at the data. He talked about some things. He's explaining some things. It's kind of interesting. It's cool. But we're tired. You know, we were expecting a short little stroll. It's like 3 hours in now when it was supposed to be 1 hour. And that's a long time when you've been going at a full pace, like it's been like exercising on a treadmill the whole time, right? And so we're going. And now it's getting dark, starting to get dark. Now we're at like the 4 or 5 hour mark. I don't remember. And he says, okay, so let's hike to where the vehicle was, the Ladas, the Russian Ladas. Let's go back there and we'll drive back to the field station. So we go there and he says, so on the way to going to the vehicles, we collected some of the other researchers who were in the field. So now there's too many of us to be in this one vehicle. So we're going to have to do multiple trips, bringing people back to the field station. So multiple trips back to the field station. My partner and I, we volunteer. Hey, we'll just relax. This is our first time in the forest. You guys have been out here all day. We'll volunteer to just chill and hang out. So off Vadim goes with his other team members, the researchers, and he's going to take them back to the field station and they depart. And we kind of have an idea of how close we are to the field station. It's not too bad. Maybe 15-minute drive one way. So we're thinking about 30 minutes, Vadim will be back. Now, this is my first exposure to this place. I have no preparation. No topo map, no materials, no food, just a little bit of extra water. That's it. And not dressed very warm either. Because we're just going out. We were going to go out for an hour. It's been like 5 now. And we're sitting there and waiting. He still hasn't come back. It's been over an hour now. We're like, what the heck? It starts getting colder and colder. There's wolves around. There's not bear. I think bear are already hibernating at this point in the year when we went and visited. I think we went in October, if I'm not mistaken. So probably no bear, but plenty of wolf and lots of lynx. Again, now that I know what I know, I'm not scared at all. But at the time, I was a little bit scared. But as the time passed on, it was getting really brutal cold. We're talking minus 20, maybe, minus 25, something like this. Finally, we decided, let's get near a tree, and we're going to get underneath the cover of the tree. We're going to wrap the branches around us and hold each other in the night to keep our warmth up. And we're like starting to make serious plans about the night. What the heck? Where'd this guy go? I don't know where to go. This forest is very disorientating. You don't know where you're at, which direction, yada, yada, yada. It's crazy. So it's about an hour and a half, if I'm not mistaken, and we see the faint lights coming down the road. Again, you're like, why don't you just walk the road? Well, the road's kind of spiderweb in this forest. We have no idea where this field station is. And it's our first few hours in this forest. I have no idea where to go. So it makes sense to stay put, of course. You always stay put in a serious situation like that. And so here he comes and he shows up, parks, opens the door, looks at me and says, oh, Josh, very sorry, sorry. We saw wolf and we chase. So apparently when he was taking the team back to the field station, they saw a wolf and they went after it. And they left me and my partner, first time being exposed to this guy, alone in the forest. And, you know, had they probably been successful at chasing the wolf, they probably would have been out all night and come back 6 hours later to pick me up. That was my first introduction to Vadim. And this story aside, Vadim, I consider him one of my dearest friends to this day. An amazing, amazing man. Sincere, genuine, strong as they come. And done such important work in research and ever since then, another thing that I just appreciate about him was that I helped polish him up a little bit, introduced him to different embassy groups, and he started doing a lot more tourism because ultimately that money that comes in helps him, you know, fund his research, fund the important work that he's doing. And so he warmed up to the idea and eventually became someone who was willing to do some of this. So those are my experiences in the Nalaboki Forest. And if you want to know more about my wolf research and learning about all of those things, look in the description below. There's tons of videos about my time there in the Nalaboki Forest.
Traveling Teacher here. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you hit the subscription button and the notification bell button below. Make sure you like this video. And for more content, stay tuned. Check out this playlist. Check out that subscription logo there. Keep traveling.